got an opportunity at the end of 2004. I got contacted and they had a position for a junior trainer. And that's where it started. Well, I think that the key is that there has to be mutual respect. You know, in our industry, you cannot really be a guy that just blows a whistle or cuts oranges or just mixes Powerade. You've got to be able to lead by example, and also to you've got to be worth your metal, that they will follow you. A lot of us has got the same knowledge, and we might not speak the same language, but there's a little general baseline there. But the player has to trust you, that's the bottom line. It's all has to do with trust, and if it becomes that, then you will, you know, you'll run up mountains and jump rivers and make big tackles and those things. And it's probably the toughest job to get them fit, because it's not nice. You have to get around that though. I can't really remember my first game. I started with the under-21s in Vodacom Cup, and it was exciting. It still is. It's something that every day is different, every match is different. I actually should go back and see how many games I've been involved in. I don't keep record of that. But I know the players that started with us were guys that just came out of school. Guys like Peter Lowe, Paul Delport, Ishmael Dolly. You know, those were guys that just started getting into the systems. And then players overseas, Dion Fury, De Kock Steenkamp, that is actually starting to get to the end of their careers. De Kock, I think, just finished. But a guy like Brannas, he was a youngster. I think he started the year after when I started. But you don't forget those type of players. We try and be calculated. We try and make good decisions with good planning, and we plan ahead. The mental strength of a player is the most important thing. His body will go, but he thinks that he's gone and out. It's happened in the past where physically we've pushed players to an extent where they probably couldn't go anymore. And they tried. And I get a little bit of not a kick out of it, but I like those players. Yesterday morning we had two of our rear players who just broke a session in half. And that for me is satisfying to see. We obviously will not push them to an extent where it's life-threatening. But when you run at a certain velocity and you've got to be able to cover a certain distance and still get up and down off the deck and be able to make a collision, which is like war, you have to be able to have massive mental strength. But accompanied with that is a real basis of top fitness. And that is the tough part, is to be able to run and run and run. Because your body will tell you at stages, I can't go anymore. I think I'd like to be a medical doctor. Maybe even in trauma. I've always wanted to be someone that does or do things outdoors, and you know, that gets involved in things outdoors. But I really like the medical atmosphere we're working within, and also that day-to-day change, the quick acting, the under pressure decision making. Dwayne Vermeulen, Stephan Kitsoff and Andries Becker, they each did 200 kilograms on the bench press. I think Stephan did 205 or 210, but he squatted over 300. The only guy I could never beat in running was Joe Peterson. He would love me to say that though. But it's true, I've chased him around field since I was 27. I'm not 27 anymore, and he knows that I've come close, I've come within a meter, but no. I think the comrades, because it's boring.